It is the night after the concert, Janet's concert, and many people have asked what happened, and so I'm going to just start from the very beginning. So I tweeted a video to Janet, pleading to see if she could help me out with seating, because of a kind of a difficult experience I had last time. Basically, I am paralyzed, I'm in a wheelchair, I had a football accident that occurred on 9/11, Michael and Janet were just a couple of the basically guiding lights that I had in my life at the time, and since then. And in fact, when I was in high school, Michael's publicist then called and was going to arrange something. It never came to fruition because of the court issues, and then his subsequent passing, unfortunately. So that's kind of just a little bit of background on me. I shared with Janet how I went back to school and graduated in the top 10% of my class, and went to law school and passed the bar. So that's just a little bit of my background. Now, yeah, I did it weeks ago, and it didn't go anywhere. Months ago. I did it months ago. It didn't go anywhere. So then the concert was about 2 weeks away, and so I said to Lamont, can you tweet, help me get this some circulation? And the Jan family respects him because it started getting so much attraction and attention. It was crazy. I got an inbox from someone, a DM, who was calling him my guardian angel. You know who you are. I'd say his name, but he kind of wants to be low key. And so he got my information, and I was like, really? I can't believe it. Like, are you really, really, really going to help me? And he said, well, I'll do what I can. So I don't know, he didn't really have this accent, but can't help it. I was going right on my way to work, and I was telling my nurse in the van, I said, I think I might meet my wife this year, Janet. And I said, you know what? I've done everything that I can. I said, up to this point, I said, if I don't meet Janet this year, it just wasn't meant to be. And I finally got peace with that. Then that same day, mind you, I'm on my way home working on the art piece that so many of you have liked, which I really appreciated. All of a sudden, I get a FaceTime. I'm thinking, well, maybe this is her people. And then I said, wait a minute, why would her people be FaceTiming me? And I said, no, 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 no. I said, what the Teyana Taylor is going on here? So I accept it, and Janet Jackson is looking me dead in my eyes. Looking fine as she want to be. Oh, my God. I was like, no. No, this is not you. It's not. And the reason why is because, I had all these dreams and fantasies of what it would be like to meet her. And truth be told, many of these involved me being her man. In my mind, I want roll up on Jen and be like, oh my gosh, you were the one all this time, the one for me. You're so beautiful, you're so cute, you're so handsome. I love your chair, and I don't know, I mean, you're just, yes, I'll marry you. And I would have been like, I know, it's been a long time, but we're finally here. I'm finally here, and we can you know, we can make this happen. In reality, I was going to Janet, oh my God. I was going to cry like a bitch. I was going to be like, oh, Janet, oh my gosh. You know, so I was like, she's like, I saw your video. And I was like, oh my God. I was like, you're not supposed to see me like this. She goes, see you like what? And she said, I'm actually supposed to be working out right now. And she said, but you're going to come to the show? And I said, yes, yes, I'm coming to the show. And she said, well, how about you come early and hang out? Hang out. Oh, my gosh. So, oh, yeah, Janet said, so do you want to bring a friend? And I was like, oh, my gosh, yes. And literally, I started thinking about all the people in my life. And then I thought, I have to take Lamont because, you know, my video didn't start really going anywhere until Lamont really shared it. And I was pretty much in disbelief. And then I was really upset. I was upset because I'm like, this didn't happen. It was like, this happened to me and I have not, like, it doesn't even feel like it happened to me. It felt like a dream, like, I have nothing to show for it. And then as the date started getting closer and closer, I'd have these moments where, like, okay, I'd start listening to her music, and that was like, you know, getting me in the mood, getting me in the zone. And then I got where I couldn't listen to the music because I'm like, the person who I've been listening to for 20 something years and who's all, like, all this voice that I've been hearing in my ears, this voice that has gotten me through so much, this person, that smile, and that person who's been dancing in my favorite videos, like Miss You Much, and Someone to Call My Lover, and You Want This, and That's the Way Love Goes, I mean, this, and Love Will Never Do, I'm going to be meeting her, and talking to her, and looking her in the face. I'm leaving so many things out of this, but okay, so I get there to the venue, and the person who greets me, like, it's gonna make me cry, is Gil. I was scared when I first met him, and I cannot believe Gil is one of the kindest, sweetest people I've ever met in my entire life. And what's strange is that, you know, and I don't know how much of, you know, I sent Mr. Snobby, I sent him, you know, the video, or not video, some articles about me or whatever. So I had absolutely no clue how much Janet or anybody in her team or anybody so I've connected to her knows about me or anything like that. But he was very attentive to me, extremely. And, you know, I thought he was just going to say, hey, I'm Gil and I hope you enjoy the show and yada yada. And then, like, he was always coming back to check on me, always, you know. And Gil has the band and the backup singers come down to meet me. And I'm thinking, okay, I thought, you know, Gil was going to be nice enough, you know, let me see sound check. And it's like, hey, man, how you doing? Enjoy it. Gil instructed these people to come down and speak to me. Who does that? Amazing. Gil motherfucking Duel DeLau, that's who. So anyway, so cut to soundcheck. Lamont and I and my nurse were just sitting there in soundcheck. And then all of a sudden, Janet leaves the stage. And so I'm thinking maybe she's going to go, you know, tend to Issa or do, you know, whatever. All of a sudden, she starts coming around. And now I can't remember whether there was this filming crew that was filming. They're trying to do a documentary and what have you. And so I, all of a sudden, she came close. She was coming my way. I'm like, no, mm-mm. Turn around. Turn it about face.
That's Janet Jackson. Oh, Janet Jackson.
And so she did. I was like, thank you, thank you. Next thing I know, she had all the backup dancers, people that I had seen like on TV and seen them. I'm like, oh, I can't wait to meet them one day. I can't wait to go over there and say, hi, my name is Keyston. You know, I blah, blah, blah. They knew about me. So she brings them all down and they're all in front of me. And Janet says, we just wanted to say hi. Man, you know, and one of the reasons why I was depressed leading up to it was because I was afraid that I won't be in the moment, that I'll be looking at, because literally when she FaceTimed me, I was looking at a pre-recorded video of Janet talking to somebody else. I mean, that's 100. Like, if I had been in my right mind, I would have gotten pictures with all of them, right? So, but for those who are like, well, where's your picture of Janet? Well, in soundcheck, you can't record anything. You know, my nurse started to record her saying hi to me, but then one person said she could record, next person said she couldn't. So literally, the only evidence that I had from that experience was about half a second, where you can see Janet next to me. So. So she said, this is everybody, and she said, this is Wiley, this is like, I'm like, I know who they are, I know all of them. You know, it was like that scene in The Matrix where like Neo wakes up and he's like, Morpheus introduces him to everybody, you know, like, this is Trinity, this is Apoc, hey, this is Switch, yo, what's up, man? So yeah, it was like the Power Rangers or some shit. It was crazy. I knew I was gonna be at a loss for words, so. Thank God I typed up the letter, so, Dear Janet, so here it is. The moment I've been dreaming about for so long. I'm writing this because I will undoubtedly be at a loss for words, certainly without anything profound to say. What do I say in this precious but very brief moment when there are literally a million things swimming through my head? That I've always wanted to ask and to say. A good place to start would be to say thank you. Thank you for being that friend in my head when I needed someone I could depend on to comfort me when I needed it most. Paralysis can create a lonely world. This has been particularly a difficult year. Thank you for carrying the light. You see, in my office, my coworkers say, sometimes the sun isn't shining and you have to bring the sunshine in with you. I call it carrying the light. As someone who's been called a light carrier, I want to thank you for carrying the light for us. Like Michael, you have a unique quality that brings light to people's lives. It touches our souls and invites us to fix what is wrong and rejoice in what is right. It's a light that is so desperately needed in our world right now. But even as the world seems to get a little darker each day, amidst all the chaos, your light brings a sense of hope for brighter days ahead. God makes no mistakes, and He is always on divine time. Like me, I know you've been through some very tough times, some public and some private, but you kept the light all the way through. Please know that every one of your struggles was meant to prepare you for this moment, this movement. We need light carriers more now than ever, especially in the music industry. You understand the power of art and the responsibility that comes with the gifts you've been given as an artist. My hope is that younger artists will use you as the shining example to temper their self-indulgent behaviors. And focus on carrying the light to make change for the better. You inspired me to give something to the world through my art, whether it's painting, songs I write, poetry, acting, etc., to apply meaning to everything I do, no matter what the content. You inspire me so much that whenever I write or record melodies, I'm always hearing your voice. Most of all, you inspire me to keep dreaming and hoping that one day I will get to walk and dance again. Lastly, thank you for the opportunity to finally tell you how I feel. While I wish one day to call you friend, it is more than enough to have the privilege of being in your presence. Love, Keystone. I got her these flowers and I painted a piece for her. And I stayed up so late working on it. It was quite hard to do. So I gave her the painting that I'd worked on so hard, and I couldn't believe it. I brought her to tears, and I was afraid that she wouldn't like it. And she showed everyone, and it was just so amazing. I wanted to get a picture of her holding the painting, but unfortunately, you know, time was running out because they had to prepare, and then. So after that, we went to catering. The food was great. I got to talk to and take pictures with Kendall and Taylor. I mean, these girls, when they just talk, you think, these girls are like, hi, how are you? Oh my gosh, yeah. But when they get on stage, man, these girls are beasts. They don't play. I mean, these girls are the truth. DJ Active, I got to meet him. He's an amazing, amazing DJ. I also got to meet a musical director, Big D. I think that's how Janet said his name. Dominique, I guess I can call you Dom now, maybe. I've been watching her since YouTube with the blonde hair and Alex and Miche and Allison Buchkowski, I think I said it right. The curvy and sexy black girl that was up there. A beast on stage, man. Oh, and Denzel and Wiley. Wiley used to scare. I told him, I said, Wiley, you scare me because he was whipping his hair. I was like, you look fierce and everything, but like the kind of fierce where you're like, I'll cut a bitch. And he's like, that's the only way, right? Yeah, he was kind of lit. They were all having a good time, and you know, meeting Janet's bodyguard Joey, meeting Randy, Janet's brother. Well, you know, he's not just Janet's brother. He's Randy Jackson, part of the Jacksons. Randy is so kind and so protective of Janet, and that's the kind of brother I want to be, and that's the kind of sister I have. Awesome people. It's so amazing to me, the aura and the glow and the spirit around her team. People she works with, you can tell she really vets people for their spirit and their kindness. And who they are, and I think that's the most important thing above all when it comes to her. It was amazing. They had a very special place for me, like right near the side of the stage, right? And at first, you know, based on the screen, I was like, oh, okay, well, I don't know how well I'll be able to see. When those screens came up, man, it was crazy. And not only did Missy Elliott come out and perform, after that, she's literally like right down in front of me. I was up on a higher level, so I couldn't just tap on her shoulder, but Missy was getting down. You know how Missy likes to dance? You know how she dances in her videos? She was doing all of that on the side of the stage, and I hate that I didn't get to take a picture with Missy Elliott. Super duper fly. Anyway, so the concert was amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. It was incredible. Incredible experience. So I'm sitting here, my heart is full, trying to be in the moment as much as I can. But then I get two passes to go, invites to Janet's after party. What? 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 Man. So we went to the after party, and I had so many motherfucking chances to get a picture with Janet, right? So the guy lets me through the rope to come up there, because at first he was like, oh, you need help finding the bathroom? The security. I was like, oh, no, I'm here for a thing. I didn't know where to go. And then Randy's assistant said, no, come on. So I got to go up there, and Janet was sitting there, and she was sitting there looking at me like, come over. And like, I was like, no. Going over there, I'm like, oh man. So I went over there, and so this was my plan. I think I made a complete ass out of myself, but this is my plan. My plan was, why don't I ask her one of my favorite questions? And you know, I know Janet's silly, and you know, I'm silly too. And I thought, and she loves action, and she loves comic stuff, and I was like, okay, great. So I said, if you can have three superpowers, what would they be? She goes, to heal, which was one of mine. And then I started to tell her about mine. I'm like, wait a minute, you didn't ask me to talk about mine. I'm like, you're trying to get your drink on. So I said, you know what, I just made a complete fool of me. And poor Lamont was like frozen. He was like, I was carrying a statue with me, dragging a statue with me around the whole night. He was just like, he was having that out-of-body experience. I at least got to FaceTime at first to get that out of my system. Lamont was so nervous. He didn't eat at craft services. or not craft catering. He didn't eat at the catering. He didn't even eat at the after party where they were like, you know, serving the really good shishi food. I was like, brother, I was like, I don't know what you want to do, but I know what I'm going to do. And she was so kind to the waiter. She's like, oh, excuse me. Thank you so much. This is good. Do you guys want anything to eat? So she's amazing. And I talked to her. I won't talk about everything I said. And I'm not going to be dramatic and pretend it was a lengthy conversation. But I did talk to her about playing Eartha Kitt. And I hope that she does that. And we talked a little bit about that. It's just like, I was amazed that I was able to have a real conversation with her. It's what I've always wanted, was to really just have a casual conversation with her. But I wanted her to see me cry so she could know just how much she means to me, but it just wouldn't come. But it's like, every time I leave though, that's when I start crying. And I don't know why that is. I think maybe because even as it's happening, I don't believe it. But anyway, get to the end, towards the end of the night, I don't see Janet anywhere. I'm like, I thought I was going to see her, because there's only one way for me to get in and out of this space. So my plan was to ask her for a picture on my way out and ask her to sign a couple t-shirts for some people in my life. I get over there and say, oh, Janet left. She had to catch a flight. What? Man, so I was done. And poor Gail, he's like, you did not get to see, take a picture? I said, no. And he's like, well, and he was right. He said, you were in the moment. And the reality is that nobody gets this experience. Nobody. I mean, it's enough for people just to get to meet her. But I got to do all of this. I got to go to the after party. And not just like one of those celebrity after parties where you don't actually get to see the star. You're just in the same vicinity. I got to sit and talk with her and have a few moments to talk with her. One of the greatest moments of my entire life. And the people that know me the best know that it's been quite a year for me. I've had some challenges. But as I tell students when I talk to them, I say behind every challenge is an opportunity. And so I've had some wonderful opportunities, and I just feel like this was the this was the best way to end the year. I just want to say thank you. I want to thank I want to thank the Jan fam, everyone, every last one of you who tweeted, retweeted the video, because the likes were great, but when you when it gets retweeted, that really helped. I want to thank, I'm just going to call you Snob, because you know who you are. I want to thank the Snob for being the guardian angel, who helped really finalize the deal. Lamont, I know you said I made your dream come true, but, you know, I owe it so much to you, Gil, and by the way, shout out to Janet's assistant, Jaime. Jaime, you're just an incredible person. You really, really are. You were so kind, and you were so patient, and I'm really somebody about respecting boundaries, and yet, you know, you gave me your information so that I could contact you if necessary, and I'm just really happy. Anyway, people, please see this tour. It's incredibly amazing. It deals with the state of the world as it is, and how we need to heal and love each other, and to, as I say, you know, carry the light, you know, and I mean, it truly is amazing. You know, I don't know any other artists out there who are using their gifts in such a way to promote and put on such a timely and conscious show. So go see it. If you want a bus to see it this time around, I'm sorry. All I can say is get your ticket to London or wherever else she's going to be performing, because it's that good. Even my nurse was like, this is greater than I even anticipated. Amazing. Anyway, all right, I've already said way too much. Signing off. Peace and love.